Today I wanted to do something a bit different and talk about my thoughts, some ideas about graffiti, because I have actually written several assignments during college about the history of graffiti, and I have some opinions, and I thought it would be fun to talk about something like that and not just tell you facts about how Minerva works, because that, it gets kind of old, doesn't it, hun? So, if you are from around here, I hope you will listen to my thoughts. And if you're just here because you were searching about graffiti, hey, what's up? I'm a person. But so anyways, basically, graffiti started happening in like the late 60s and into the 70s in like Philadelphia and New York, right? And in the beginning, it was just like tagging. Like you were trying to get your street name to be seen in as many places as possible in the most visible places. And it evolved from just like using a marker to write your name into like the big spray paint pieces. Basically, this was mostly done by like underprivileged, marginalized kids. And I think it's interesting in particular that it was mostly kids, like teenagers, that did this. And I also think it's particularly interesting that the natural evolution of the practice was to make the pieces not only bigger, but better, and better in an aesthetic way. Like in a way that I think from an aesthetic, like art philosophical standpoint, you have to recognize as a evolution in terms of like the beauty, attractiveness, and demonstration of skill, as well as the ability for the pieces to increasingly actually like convey messages and communicate ideas beyond just this is my name. Because those beginnings of just name writing really show how these like marginalized kids wanted an outlet and sort of a way that they could feel recognized, that they could feel like they were seen by all of society. Because being like a kid in like the worst areas of New York City, you get told a lot, directly and indirectly, that like you're invisible and you don't matter. You get told this through like public policy that doesn't give you good housing. You get told this through like news not reporting on the sort of crime that affects your life, and you get this through like having a really hard time accessing opportunities to break the poverty cycle or anything like that. And so I think it's really cool that kids found this way to express themselves. So that's like opinion number one that I hold on graffiti. Opinion number two is potentially slightly more controversial. I'm gonna start by telling you that, somewhat related to opinion number one, but also for other reasons, I don't entirely agree with the extent to which graffiti is criminalized. I think the illegality goes further than is really justifiable based on what the quote-unquote crime is. Let's get into the other reasons behind that. When you ask yourself, why would people not want graffiti to be done, there's actually a couple things at play that I see as the main things. The first is sort of this like broken glass theory of crime control. I don't know if crime control is like the technical term, but basically this idea is that in creating a sense of safety in an urban area, specifically in particular, whatever, people are most affected psychologically by the crimes that are the most visible. So like, if there's broken glass, that's why it's called broken glass, if there's a lot of broken glass in the streets, that makes people feel unsafe. Even if there's another street with like, let's say an equal rate of robbery, murder, what have you, if the second street doesn't have broken glass, people feel safer, even if the more serious crime rates are the same. And so what happened in New York City, at least, which is where I know the most about sort of how graffiti policies played out. In New York City, the mayor wanted people to feel safer because people felt like New York was falling apart. It was in disrepair. It was just a hellhole of crime. And he focused on this broken glass idea and on the idea that he should just address the visible crime, which doesn't really do anything to affect the real crime rate, but it makes the average citizen feel like it does. So, besides broken glass, what is the next most visible indicator that's associated with crime in cities? Graffiti. But then we must ask ourselves, why is graffiti even a crime? Why do we even put it in that category? And this goes to thing number two, which is the concept of private property. The reason, at like the base level, that graffiti is a crime is because people are marking somehow someone else's private property without that person's, that owner's permission to mark it in that way. This kind of puts it in like a similar category of like stealing, except you're not taking anything. You're just like scribbling on it. So to me, this idea puts graffiti as like a lower offense than stealing, because it affects private property, but it affects it more superficially because the person still owns the thing. You have just altered the state of that thing which they own without their permission. This is where it becomes complicated and more opinion-based and controversial, is because this is only fair if you philosophically believe that people have a right to own private property, which basically means you believe that capitalism is like a justified system. Even if we do accept that that capitalism is a justified system, there is also the complication that it's possible that even if you alter something without someone's permission, they might like it. And if they do like it, then does that change the criminal status of what you did? So that would still make graffiti risky, but it would not make it 100% criminal in the same way, if that's your philosophical belief. So then we have to wonder as well why people think graffiti is not something you should like, or why they think it's something that degrades appearance as opposed to adding to the appearance. So basically, like, why do people think graffiti is ugly is what the question becomes. This is where I think the two things start to affect one another, because I think that without this sort of popular narrative that graffiti is a sign of crime, so that sort of broken glass approach, if police and mayors and legislators weren't saying
graffiti is a sign of crime,
maybe more people would like it, and so there wouldn't be as much opinion that it should be considered criminal. But there would always be the issue that every piece of graffiti is different, and I think that we can agree that objectively, some pieces are more ugly and unwanted than others. So because of this, it would be very difficult to ever make graffiti completely legal, because there needs to be some way for people to stop children from drawing penises on their houses. Like, that is fair. That's assuming that you're totally okay with capitalism. Although, like, any other economic system would have different complications for graffiti, which is why I don't necessarily want to get into that right now. My issue is that I don't think it's entirely justified for graffiti to be seen as ugly, as, like, the base condition, because I think a lot of graffiti is actually quite pretty and can add to the character and beauty of a city. So that's my sort of opinion on graffiti, and because of that, I think some of the potential punishments for graffiti are really excessive, like way more than it would ever be justified to punish somebody, especially if the thing that they are painting is pretty. The problem is that the laws and that, like, general popular opinion that graffiti means crime, which means harsher punishments for graffiti, therefore circles back to affect the graffiti writers and the graffiti itself. And when people are more afraid of the consequences of getting caught, they do not stop, but they want to lower the chances that they do get caught, and so they make pieces that can be done quicker. So the thing is that, like, really beautiful graffiti pieces usually take a longer time to put up. And this means you're there in the act for longer, which increases the odds that you will get caught. So what happens when you are more afraid of being caught? You do pieces that take less time and are therefore more likely to be ugly. So, like, by making the punishments worse, they actually made the graffiti uglier, which kind of then reinforces this idea that it's a sign of crime and, like, the degradation of society. When in reality, if that initial reaction to graffiti had been different, if it hadn't become part of this broken glass theory of crime, we could have had such pretty cities. Like, this whole phenomenon with the graffiti is part of why I personally take some problem with the idea of private property in like a purely capitalist sense of the word. When property is government-owned or somehow shared or public, why would the general public not have some right to beautify that place? And you might say now that you have to just like
go through the process to get approved for a mural.
But the thing is that that institutionalization of graffiti into street art just serves to block out those like marginalized populations that initially started the whole thing, because it tends to be a lot harder for people with fewer resources to get through those kinds of processes or even to know about those kinds of processes that one might go through in order to be able to get the right to paint a mural, for example. I don't have a solution. I don't have an answer. I'm just annoyed with the US for telling us that graffiti is an ugly sign of crime and decay. I really loved, when I lived in Berlin, that the like consequences are lower. Basically, you don't really go to jail in Berlin for graffiti. You just have to pay a fine. The fine can get pretty massive because I think it's based on how big the area that you painted is. Because of this, there's tons of beautiful graffiti in Berlin. And it's like, a lot of it is illegal. It's not like it's all like approved legal street art. That's not the deal, which is generally the case when you see like a really good mural in a place like LA, because the police crack down on graffiti in those areas. But Berlin is beautiful because it is a little bit more tolerant of graffiti. And I like that. This has been my opinion. Basically, history has doomed us once again, and we cannot undo it. And I'm sad about it. That's the video.